All right, here's the entrance to the Texas Pinball Festival,
2011. There's a
Monopoly
up for a raffle, and that's the tournament area. They're mostly rolling stones, which are new. I don't know if they're 2010 or 2011 pinball machines by Stern, which is the last remaining pinball manufacturer. I think there's another one called Jersey Jack that's going to be releasing new ones.
As far as I know, right now,
I think it's just Stern Pinball. Iron Man's 2010, so those are all pretty new. And then there's something, I don't know, Genie, looks pretty old. That might be for the Electromechanical Tournament, not sure. Anyway, as you can see, tournament area.
Actually a lot brighter than it was yesterday.
It was very dark yesterday. Some old video games. A lot of these pinball machines are turned off. It's sort of disappointing. They're either not working, I guess some of them are sold as well. There's a tournament area again. The older machines.
Here's the Pinbot trilogy, Pinbot, Rider Pinbot, and Jackbot. Most people know Rider Pinbot.
What do we got over here?
This is a really cool game, Black Knight 2000.
Played this yesterday a couple of times.
It's an update to Black Knight, as you would have guessed. But it was not released in 2000, it was released in 1989. It's got this kind of flash, Queen type rock opera soundtrack. It's pretty cool, actually. It's got two play fields, an upper level and a lower level.
Another Pinbot, Rider Pinbot. One of these old, or not old, one of these multi-game emulators.
Johnny Mnemonic, never saw the movie, never played the game.
This game has a ton of drop targets, but it's really. Pretty much no other goal there than to hit all the drop targets. No ramps, no nothing. No lock balls. I didn't even know you can do, I don't think you can do multi-ball either. Got some more pins hidden in the corner there. A guy selling a bunch of old pinball parts. Actually recognized that little guy from Cirque Voltaire. Gosh. Our render showing off the LEDs.
This is a really cool game.
Xenon.
They've actually altered it.
Blue LEDs.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a different one from yesterday. They used to have one with a different score display. I was told they were called Nixie Tubes. I'd never really heard of them before, but these are just straight up old school LEDs. So, pretty sweet looking machine though. Looks like they've begun to tear down. All these were up and running last night, all torn down. That's the thing that sucks about coming on the last day. Everybody's kind of tearing shit down. The lights are up a little bit higher because everybody's working on stuff. There's a back door open. There's a bunch of mechanical stuff. Here's the booth by Pinball Arcade, which is from Austin. Actually, I have two Twilight Zone machines here, and both of them are broken in different ways. So that's sort of disappointing. two F-14 Tomcat machines. This one doesn't work so well. The playfield isn't really lit correctly. Some older machines.
Looks like these are all Bally. Yeah, they're all Bally.
Now this game is a terrible game. And you should be able to tell just from the back out there. It's a really bad Top Gun ripoff. That's not Tom Cruise. Goldwings. It plays pretty poorly too. Another meteor. For some reason there's a ZVS arcade game here. Another row of games. It's Frankenstein. I'm surprised it hasn't sold. $1,400. I didn't really care for it when I played it. Ooh, Super Mario Brothers is working today. It was not working yesterday. I'm going to start the game real quick. There's a ball already in play. Let's see. Oh, that's why. Plunger doesn't work. It's an auto plunger and it's not working. Oh well. Some more pins. This is a kind of a cool bowling and a skee ball bowling shuffleboard type game. I want to look at the pinball as well, it's pretty fun. Another pinball, pinball is a pretty popular series.
My turn.
That's pretty cool looking game, Bonsai War. Go ahead. Go ahead. Don't have time to play now, I gotta record all this stuff. Medieval Madness, I'm really surprised I'm looking at one of these. Because it is extremely popular. Metro Mars is pretty cool because it's actually got a screen, a video screen, being mirrored from underneath. And you actually interact with the mirrored image. It sort of looks kind of holographic. Really fun game, but it ends up being more about just shoot the holographic targets than anything else. The Star Wars game is also the same series, the Pinball 2000 series. You can see the holograph. So those are the two Pinball 2000 series. The Mars, so this one's broken. Not working.
But close.
Alright. Another jackpot. By Hunter. It's surprising to see how many arcade games, popular arcade games, were turned into pinball games. I was surprised to find that there was a Defender pinball game. I used to have it at Pinballs, but it was never working, and they've since removed it from the floor. I used to play this a lot back in arcade days. For some reason, they had one of these. It looks really old, but they had one of these in the arcade I used to play at.
Another one of those bowling games. Another getaway. I don't know how many times I've passed that already.
Pretty sweet Tron machine. They have a really nice Tron machine at Arcade Pinball. I mean, at Pinball's Arcade in Austin.
Really nice condition. Boards. Another high speed.
There's high speed and high speed 2, the getaway. Two in that series. A couple of Star Trek games. This one's highly regarded, as I believe. If it's the 93 one, I think it is. Pretty interesting playfield.
I never played it, but a lot of people like it.
No, go ahead.
Yeah, there's an old 79 Star Trek. Taxi, there's a few of those around. And his family, there's a couple of those at least. Here's the original Black Knight. I showed you Black Knight 2000 earlier. This also has a dual playfield setup. It's a lot more boring, as far as I'm concerned. The other one's awesome. This one's, you know, this one's okay. I'm surprised they made a sequel to it. Probably a lot of people liked it. This game is terrible. It's not lit. It's called Strange Science. Along with Golden Wings, it's one of two games that we saw that were just direct, non-licensed rip-offs of popular movies of the time. Strange Science for Weird Science and Golden Wings for Top Gun. It was another high speed. Next to a police force. I don't think that's part of the series. Maybe, but I don't think so. There's High Speed and High Speed 2 The Getaway. Anyway. So here, there's The Getaway, High Speed 2. Hook is a terrible gate, and I'm glad it's turned off. I played that last night. With the most annoying music. Another taxi. Big stop. Funhouse, funhouse, funhouse. And there are other funhouses. Littered about. Another ass family. That's actually a pretty fun game. Attack of Mars, which is the first of the Mars series, which was a traditional pinball game. The other one I showed you was the Pinball 2000 with the screen. This was just a pretty straight pinball. It's also very popular. This is the Medieval Madness of the two biggies from the mid to late 90s. I think they're 96, 97-ish. Here, this is pretty good. Mirror Magic's pretty fun too. Hey boy.
Nice,
man. Cross of 1812 is not for me. We played that a while back and all that. It's just a brain monster. Everything is brain, brain, brain. This is a pretty cool game. I played this a few times yesterday. I couldn't figure out what the hell I was doing. Eventually I started to figure out what I was supposed to do, but it's a... I don't know, the poker theme seems a little loose. Some old electromechanical... Oh, they got a new bat. It was broken yesterday.
I could swear I have one of those on my screen.
Oh, wait. There's
another baseball game. Actually, it's the same one. No, it's different. Old ass electromechanical gate. There's another one now. I think we've come around. The taxi again, and Gorgar. And another pinball. Alright, I think I've taken you around. So this has been Texas Pinball Festival 2011. Again, this is the last day of the show, so there's probably some machines that have been taken down that we've missed. Pretty cool. I'm a little sad that we got here so late. Yesterday, we got here basically the day before they closed. All the tournaments were pretty much wrapped up for most of them. They had some conferences or some talks by some pretty big people in the pinball industry, and we missed all those. So hopefully next year we can find this a little bit better and make it out here for the entire weekend. Alright, hope you enjoy the video.